My name is Kermet Sultan. I am a citizen of the Republic of Kazakhstan. I proved the legendary Collatz conjecture, and in this video, I briefly explain my proof. First, showing a few slides, some information about the Collatz conjecture is given, and then I will show you a graph tree that proves the correctness of the Collatz conjecture. The Collatz conjecture is named after the German mathematician Lothar Collatz, who formulated this conjecture in 1937. Hopeless. Absolutely hopeless. Mathematics may not be ready for such problems. Professor Paul Erdos. You can get as close as you want to the Collatz conjecture, but it's still out of reach. Professor Terence Tao. To explain the Collatz conjecture, we take any natural number n, if it is even, divide it by 2, and if it is odd, multiply by 3 and add 1, we get 3n+1, we perform the same actions on the resulting number, and so on. Collatz conjecture is that no matter what the initial number n is, sooner or later we get 1. If the calculations start with the odd number 19, then the sequence of numbers comes to 1 in 20 steps. To clarify the proof, we group the natural numbers. Natural numbers consist of even and odd numbers. Odd numbers can be divided into odd multiples of 3 and odd numbers not multiples of 3. Odd numbers that are not multiples of 3 can be divided into odd numbers calculated by the formula 6m-1. Odd numbers calculated using the formula 6m+1. The following table shows natural numbers up to 100. In which the four groups of numbers described above are colored in different colors. Even numbers are blue. Odd multiples of 3 are orange. Numbers 6m-1 are yellow. And numbers 6m+1 are green. If we remove even numbers and numbers that are multiples of 3, we get the numbers we need. Starting number. By the condition of the conjecture, the calculation of the Collatz function can be started from any natural number. Obviously, it is more efficient to start with an odd number, since any even number when divided by 2, 1 or more times, will turn into an odd number. Odd numbers can be divided into odd multiples of 3, 3n, and odd numbers that are not divisible by 3, k equals 6m minus or plus 1. Hence the following question arises. What odd numbers are more efficient to start the calculation with? It follows from the above that if the calculation of the Collatz function is performed only on the basis of odd numbers of the form 6m-1 and 1, then the result will be equivalent to the calculation of the Collatz function on the basis of any natural number. To establish the numbers related to each other, we carry out the inverse calculation. It follows from formula that with an increase in the value of the exponent of 2q, the values of kg and k1 increase, and this will continue indefinitely. The following table shows the precursor seed numbers. This is just the beginning of an infinite table. We will consider only the numbers located on the first 6 columns of the table. Friends, we will now construct a small fragment of the Collatz graph tree using the data from this table shown on the previous slide. There are an infinite number of numbers associated with the number 1, but in the table only 3 numbers are shown, related to number 1 and other numbers. You can read in the book why we use numbers exactly in 6 columns, and not in 4 or 5 columns. One of these 3 numbers is divisible by 3, so such numbers will not be shown on the graph. First, we take the ball corresponding to the number 1 and connect the 5th ball with it, because if we look at the table, then the numbers 1, 5, 21 are associated with the number 1. We continue to build a graph, taking into account the relationship of numbers. If we look at the table, then the numbers 13, 53 are associated with the number 5, then the numbers 17, 277 are associated with the number 13, and the numbers 35, 565 are associated with the number
53.
This is a small graph that connects the numbers 1, 5, 13, 53, 17, 277, 35, 565. Thus, if we continue to build a graph using a table of connected numbers, we can get a fragment of any size of the Collatz tree graph. If we show only numbers up to 1,000 on the graph, we get the following asymmetric tree graph. Of course, we have constructed only a small fragment of the infinite Collatz graph tree, but through this fragment we can understand the correctness of the Collatz conjecture, because it is clear that any number in the graph is connected to the number 1. For example, if we calculate the Collatz function starting from the odd number 295, we get a sequence of numbers, marked in red in this figure, connected to the number 1. If the graph shows even numbers and numbers in multiples of 3, then the graph will have the following form. In fact, the graph will be visual if it is three-dimensional. But we will not build a three-dimensional graph to save time. As you can see on the graph, ball number 5 connects to the ball number 3. Ball number 53 connects to the ball number 141. Here you can see that the numbers which is divisible by 3 are in brown color, and even numbers are colored in blue, and it is seen that numbers that are divisible by 3 doesn't affect on the graph at all. For example, number 69 associated with the number 13, and then it goes to the number 5, and finally comes the number 1. Friends, details of the proof of Collatz conjecture are given in the author's book, which is available for pre-order from Amazon. The layout of the book is as follows. From the content of the book, it is clear that the book contains answers to many questions related to the Collatz conjecture. In conclusion, I would like to say the following. Friends, buy my book and try to find an uncorrectable error in my proof of the conjecture, because I will give $1,000 to the first person who does it. In fact, my proposal is marketing for the book, because there is no error in my proof of the Collatz conjecture. My work was checked by several professors, and they did not find an error in my proof of the conjecture. Don't worry if you don't find fault with my proof, because using my method you can solve another mathematical problem. For example, juggler sequence, or juggler conjecture, is similar to Collatz conjecture. Thanks and good luck to you all.